uplifting to see so many people here today. There is an old saying in the workers' movement, don't mourn, organise. And that's what we're doing here today. We're organising, we're mobilising. And we will keep doing so until we win justice. Palestine is the moral and political issue of our time. Like the civil rights movement in America, like the movement against apartheid in South Africa, like the movement against the Vietnam War, like the fight against fascism, we stand in a long tradition of people fighting for justice. And in these moments, you have to pick a side. You have to know what side you're on. And our government, they have chosen a side. Our government, this shameful Labour government, has chosen the side of the oppressor. Israel, in their eyes, can do no wrong. Israel, in their eyes, is like a favourite son or daughter. Israel, in their eyes, is a plucky little country surviving against the evil, powerful Palestinians. This is an absolute inversion of the truth. Israel is a nuclear-armed military power, and the Palestinian people are an indigenous population standing up for their rights. But Labour's support for Israel is not new. Did you know in 1948, when so-called Israel was established, the president of the UN General Assembly was the Labour leader, Doc Evatt. He was the one who passed the motion creating Israel. So their support for oppression goes way back. And they signed off on the Nakba, happily. And now they will sign off on the new Nakba in Gaza, happily. The mainstream media. What do we think of the media? The mainstream media have picked a side. Every day, we are subjected to interviews with IDF generals, with war criminals, people whose professional job was killing innocent people, in facilitating the settlement of the West Bank. Every day, you listen to the ABC, you hear these scum being interviewed. Where are the Palestinian voices? Where are the people of Gaza's voices? Never heard. Instead, we're told the Israelis are defending themselves. Well, let's do a bit of a fact check. 80% of people in Gaza are surviving only on international aid. Israel has put them under siege for 16 years. Is that self-defense? One more time, is that self-defense?
No!
30% of the homes in Gaza have been damaged or destroyed in the last 2 weeks. Is that self-defense?
No!
Half the population of Gaza are kids, children, teenagers. Is bombing this place, is bombing these people self-defense? Malcolm X once warned us that if you take the media seriously, they'll have you loving the oppressors and hating their victims. He was absolutely right. So listen to real media like Red Flag, putting down the truth. The Americans have also picked a side. Donald Trump said if he was the president of America, he would have already invaded Gaza by now. And he said, if he becomes president next year, he will put another ban on all Muslims entering America. But President Joe Biden, the man who was supposed to save the world from Donald Trump, has he been any better?
No.
Joe Biden has said Israel can do whatever it likes. Joe Biden has sent two aircraft carriers to the Middle East to show the world who's boss. In his most recent speech, Joe Biden congratulated America on responding so well to this situation. He said, America is the glue that holds the world together. America, the country responsible for the war in Iraq. The country responsible for the war in Afghanistan. The country responsible for hundreds of wars across the world. The truth is that American imperialism is a cancer on the face of humanity. It needs to be stopped. And Victorian Socialists are the only party in Australia calling for the Australia-US alliance to be torn up. Australia should no longer be allied to this monstrosity. But I gotta wrap up. We wanna take to the streets, so I wanna say, on the other side of the line of history are all of you, all of us. We are taking the side of justice. So give yourselves a round of applause. We are part of an international movement. In Washington and New York, my favorite story, thousands of Jewish leftists got together to protest, to blockade Congress. 400 of them put their bodies on the line and got arrested for the cause to say that this is not a religious conflict, it's a political one. It's about occupation. And the Palestine struggle is a long struggle, it's a hard struggle, but it's an important one. So comrades, let's end on a chant. Israel out of West Bank.
Israel out of West Bank.
Israel out of Gaza.
Israel out of Gaza.
Israel out of Palestine.
Israel out of Palestine.
Long live the Intifada.
Long live the Intifada.
Free, free Palestine.